Today we are building confidence and money. My name is Marcus. This is Discover Ignite, where we discover possibilities and ignite change. And today I'm actually doing a book review for you guys on a book called Money or Your Life by Vicki Robbins, Joe Dominguez, and Mr. Mustache. So hold on, stick tight. Let's get this book review started. So I've been on this kick with money, right? And trying to just learn more about investing, learn more about, you know, money skills and a bunch of other different opportunities and investments. And so for myself, I picked up this book. I did a Google search and I found this book right off of somebody's blog. They ranked it as number one out of the top five that they ranked. And I believe I've read two other books on that list. But nonetheless, this book came up. And so I was intrigued by it because those other two books I had read, they were pretty good books. So I was looking forward to this book to see what it had to offer, and I was not at all disappointed. This book was very well put together, and it really talks about the relationship with money, right? Our relationship with money, I think, is tainted at a young age. We all believe that, you know, money is the root of all evil, and, you know, you go into adulthood thinking the same thing, right? Like, you don't want to be too greedy, you don't want to be that person. But in fact, you know, money is a tool, and it's okay to go after money, right? It's a tool to provide those things for your friends, for your family, for your community, and buy those things that you want for them, right? Make sure that they're secure, make sure that the community is good, make sure that you can, you know, donate, right? And not feel like you can't donate because you can't pay the rent, right? And so this book changes that relationship with money. And I think a lot of people, you know, coming out of like high school especially, they should read a book like this, right? This is really basic concepts and ideas that can really help you. And even for me, right, it really helped me just to get a good overall understanding of money and my relationship with money, right? And I think that's one of those things, when those relationships, you got to kind of really keep in check, right, and make sure that, you know, your relationship with money is healthy, right? You're not being driven by money, and realize that this book really puts that in those concepts, right? And to realize that you are exchanging essentially your time, which is the most precious thing that you could ever own, for dollars. And it calculates that stuff, right? Like, next time you go out, you know, next time you go out to buy something that you think really doesn't matter, right? It's just a couple bucks, right? Well, how long did it take you to make that, right? $5, say whatever that item is $5. Well, how long did it take you to make that $5? Did it essentially require you the first 20 minutes of your day at the workday to get that one little item that you thought was no big deal, right? And I think a lot of times, you know, I talk about this death of a thousand cuts, spending on a bunch of little things that add up to that, you know, that you wonder where your money's all going because of those small little purchases that you have. When you put it in this context, right, you really start thinking about money a lot different, right? And that's ultimately what you have to do, is change that relationship, change this idea, this perspective on money, and that can really help you, right? Because ultimately you can sit there and write everything down. You're going to be bored out of your mind. I know for myself, you know, I've tried to do this budget thing, and I do budgeting, but I do use an app, and I try to write it out all out and do an Excel sheet, right? And the thing is that it's hard, right? It's hard to keep up with something like that, right? For myself, again, I use an app, so it makes it much easier to be able to do that, to see where my money is going. But this book really breaks it down, right? It even wants you to go really precise on things that you're spending, right? Because it ultimately talks about, you know, auditing yourself and finding where all those little pennies are essentially going. Now, it's not saying you have to go down to every penny, but it says it wants you to round up, you know, to the nearest dollar, just so you are as accurate as can be, and really see where that money is going. And a lot of times you can play a game out of this, right? Well, how much money can I save, right? If I can, you know, go a couple days and buy this thing that's, you know, maybe $2 or $3 cheaper, and, you know, then you can play that death by a thousand cuts, but in a positive aspect, right? To where I save $2 here, I save $2 there, and all that adds up, right? Eventually, throughout the year, that stuff adds up, as long as you are mindful of these things. And that's ultimately what it is when it's talking about, you know, auditing yourself. It's just like when you do your dieting, right? If you go into like bodybuilding, you know, they count calories and all that stuff, and a lot of people don't want to do that, but it's the same kind of concept that you're applying to money, right? If you are trying to get in the prime shape of your life, right, and you're trying to get a six pack and you're trying to do all these different things, you have to count calories. You have to see where your calories are coming from, and it's the same kind of aspect when you're looking at money, right? Money's the same way. You have to know where your money is going. You have to pay attention to where your money is going. And this essentially, once you do this after a while, you kind of get a grasp of it. And then eventually, like myself, like I don't count calories anymore. I know if I eat this meal, this is so many X amount of calories, right? And so same kind of thing with money, that transitions over. And so you're thinking that money, okay, well, you know, if I just spend on these normal things I normally buy, I know essentially where I'm gonna be by the end of the week, right? And if there's some random expense that comes up, well, hey, you know, I kind of already know where I'm standing and how much maybe a wiggle room I have. And so this book really kind of breaks that stuff down for you, and it gets more into it, right? It talks about, again, a bunch of different things revolving around money. And then towards the end, it does talk about investing a little bit, which I think is really good because, you know, a lot of people don't know where exactly to invest their money, right? A lot of people want to just throw in a 401k and let someone else manage it, but that's ultimately another thing I don't believe you should want to do, right? You should want to be knowledgeable about that stuff, because a lot of times, a lot of these fees that you're paying someone else to manage your money, you lose out on a lot of money. And that, you know, would be a completely other different video, because I mean, you do lose out on a lot of money through your lifetime. You lose a lot of money if you can just, you know, get the basic concepts, the grasp of money and finances. You could really do a number on your finances and completely change your life. And that's what this book is essentially built for, is to change your thought process. You can change your life and essentially be free, right? Because that's ultimately where we want to be. That's why we use money as a tool, to ultimately just be free, right? And do those things that we want and not do those things that we have to do to pay the bills. And so as far as like any cons to this book, I really didn't have any cons of this book, right? This book was pretty well put together, and a lot of times it seemed like a lot of stuff was really basic, but a lot of just really good ideas just kept pumping out throughout this book, right? And kind of kept you aligned. It didn't stray too far or anything like that. It kept everything in sync. And again, it had some great tips on investing on the back end of the book, which I thought was great for a lot of people who may not, you know, do any kind of research or understand any kind of investing ideas and what you can invest in. And so it again goes into some of that, which I really did appreciate at the end, right? Because a lot of this stuff is kind of reiterating what I've been learning. And so again, it was a great book. I love this book. If you are interested in this book, I'll actually leave it down in the description. And also, if you do enjoy this video, remember to like this video on the way out. And until next time, I will see you guys later.